Today I'm reviewing Pentel Oil Pastel for Artists. Hi, I'm Cynthia. If you like oil pastels, if you like art in general and you want to be inspired, subscribe and hit the bell because I make a bunch of videos every week. I was very, very excited to review and test this set because I had never heard of it until one of you recommended it to me. I do really love Pentel Arts because they're very inexpensive and they work really well. I'm talking about the student grade quality. I made a full review of that set here if you want to watch it after this. So seeing that there was an artist quality oil pastel from Pentel, I was so curious and excited to try it because the cheaper version is very inexpensive and performs very well for the price. My expectations for this set are very high. First thing to note is that it's a 25-piece set. There's also a 50-piece set. This 25-piece, I paid $25. It's not really available around my area. I live in Canada. And I think it's kind of only available in Japan. Someone can maybe correct me if I'm wrong. So I had to make an order on eBay, and that comes with some shipping fees, so it upped the price. But the set itself is $25, which is very, very reasonable for an artist quality. I tried gathering as much information as I could about this set because there's nothing on the box or in the box explaining anything, and I couldn't find much, honestly. So I can't guarantee that this set is light fast for those who are looking for a light, fast, archival type of pastel. It doesn't say that it is anywhere. It's a small square stick as opposed to the regular round sticks. And when I say small, I mean that the student quality Pentel Arts is also a smaller stick compared to other brands who have like a chubbier kind of oil pastel stick. Honestly, I like the square format. I wish they were all square because it prevents them from rolling everywhere, and I like the sharp edges. In swatching these colors, I was happy to see that they're very, very pigmented. I always find that within a set of oil pastels, there are colors that are naturally less pigmented than others. Usually the problem areas are the lighter shades. Very often it's the pinks, the purples, light greens. And I'm really happy to report that there are no pigment problems in this set. Everything is very, very pigmented. Nice and opaque. Even the flesh colors go very smoothly on the paper. You don't see any patchiness. Everything looks really, really great. I also did a blending test to see how many layers I could get away with before things start peeling off, because at some point there's just too much material on the paper. The paper can only take so much. But I was able to get multiple layers before I started to feel that little peeling off effect. I didn't have any problems blending it with my fingers. Everything looked very smooth and nice. I also wanted to compare it to other brands that are in the same quality range. So I compared the same shade, Cobalt Blue, with Crepas Specialist Set, with Mungio Gallery, as well as the Pentel Student Grade, which is Pentel Arts. The results for that quick comparison, it's not scientific by any means. I'm just visually seeing that the Specialist Set is less pigmented and it's also an artist grade quality. The Specialist Set is certified to be light fast. The Mungio Gallery is as pigmented, if not a little bit more pigmented. And if I compare it to the Pentel Arts, the student quality, there's a big difference in pigment, which makes me really happy. Because if you're gonna pay 5 times more for a set from the same brand, there has to be good reason for that. And I think that in that case, they delivered. The Pentel Artist is a lot more pigmented and opaque than their student range. Another thing to note is the consistency, the texture, and the creaminess. I find that there are different textures. The cheaper, less quality oil pastels tend to have a more slippery, slippy, silicone-y type of texture. That's what Pentel Arts, the student quality, is like. It's more silicone-y and slippery. and you can see through it. And then there's the buttery kind, the really smooth, buttery, creamy kind, which are obviously the top quality Sennelier, which are the most expensive oil pastels. And the Mungyo Gallery is also very, very smooth and buttery. Not as smooth as the Sennelier, but it goes on smooth on the paper. Sennelier will melt under the warmth of your finger. Mungyo Gallery wouldn't do that, but it still goes very creamy on the paper. This set, Pentel for Artists, is different. It's firmer. It's the firmest that I've tried so far, but I still really like to use them, and I think that actually, it's a good thing for the first layer of a drawing because they tend to really stick to the paper, and you don't really want a first layer to kind of move around because it makes it harder to put more colors on top of it. I love that this set is very, very pigmented. I don't have any problems with any colors. I think the blending goes very well. I like that it's a firmer stick, that it really sticks down to your paper. It's pretty affordable considering the quality, $25 for 25 sticks. The only problem is that it's not really available near me for now. I would really love to have the 50-piece set. I think it's worth the money. If it becomes available in my area, I will purchase it for sure. I hope this was helpful. If you want more inspiration, watch this next. I'm in love with you.